Welcome to a crowdsourced stream today. We're going to have just a lot of fun today. I have this camera in my shot because we're going to be playing with this bad boy, the Rodecaster Pro. Now, I've had this in my studio for a little while, but I haven't really been using it to its full capabilities. And okay, here's the absolute truth. Tell me if anybody can relate to this. I have so many pieces of gear to put into production and test. I have so many things that I'm doing on the business side and creating content in general. But like my plate is way overloaded right now. And so sometimes getting a piece of gear into its fullest of capabilities in my production, it takes time. And, you know, that's one of the things that you do have to realize, that when you do add a piece of gear to your studio, I totally forgot to change shirts. Whoops. I totally didn't. That's just spaced on me until I saw myself right now. But sometimes it's just like, I don't really have time to dig in. So I thought I would crowdsource a little, some tips from you guys, but also show you what the Rodecaster can do. So it's a crowdsourced kind of a show today. And if you are really experienced at the Rodecaster Pro and you would, okay, I'm just gonna do this. I had the idea during the countdown timer and I haven't really thought it through. This is dangerous, me doing what I'm about to do. But if you are really good at the Rodecaster Pro and you wanna hop on with me today and actually maybe go through some stuff with me to get it set up to its fullest capability, then hey, let's do this together. And I can share the link, but I'm going to request that when I share my interview link, I'm going to put it in the main chat. However, only if I call your name and ask you to come up, please only click the link from that perspective, okay? All right. You know what? This was a last minute one. I wasn't able to get a hold of anyone, but I think that this would be kind of fun. So if you do want to, you can let me know. I'm going to first show, and by the way, mods, if somebody does speak up and say that they would like to, if you can throw their name in our chat, that way I can see that, because I may miss some of those. Okay. I'm not saying there's such a thing as too much gear. Absolutely not. I'm just saying that I sometimes just don't have like the time to dedicate. So I figure I would, kind of do it on the show here so that I'm killing two birds with one stone. No, that's a, you know what? That's a really, really horrible phrase. That is the like worst phrase of all. Who came up with that? I don't want to kill birds. That's just bad. Oh, that's a bad one. Okay, so have I thought about Amazon Live? I have some people that we're looking at bringing on. I'm not part of, I just haven't signed up for the influencer program. I probably should. That is a good idea. Hey, Callie, write that down. I need to sign up for the Amazon influencer program. Yeah, exactly. Don't kill the birds. No. Feed two birds with one scone. All right, we'll go with that one. Okay, so this is the Rodecaster Pro. And if you're unfamiliar with it, and I know that I am really late to the game with bringing in some of the content around this, but this is the Rodecaster Pro. It's like a mixer plus. Okay, so it can take four XLR mics. I only have one plugged in. You'll see that the rest are inactive. But also you can bring in a USB connection, a Bluetooth connection, and Bluetooth connection and your phone as well. But then it also has all of these sound effects. Yeah, no. Oh. So you can program these to be whatever you want. They just give you some to start. Oh, wait, here. Let's do this one. Whoops, wrong one. Hold on. Those two together work well. There we go. Okay, so you can actually have a lot of fun with this by putting in your own sound effects, music, that kind of thing, to make it really easy to produce. And you can, let me get back to the main screen here. You can see your sound levels up here. You can record. A lot of people actually use this for recording your podcasts. And so it's a really fantastic device. Now, I'm currently, I have only been using it for just my mic, bringing my Rode NTG4 mic. But today, you guys are gonna help me decide which sound effects we should add to my board. What do you think about that? Yes, you can absolutely do it with Stream Deck as well if you set that up in advance, for sure. And I have things like... So like that was my, that's through Stream Deck and through Ecamm, where I have my dance it out music, right? Every time we do that. And it's not for everybody. If you're using a USB mic, by the way, this is not a device for you. This is only for XLR mics, right? That's how you're gonna bring that in. Oh, John says we want Alter. Well, guess what? I actually already programmed that. Now, let me talk about Stream Deck versus Rodecaster Pro, because, well, the way I have it set up using Loopback, which is something we'll talk about in another stream altogether, but so the way I have it, and I'm just going to go into demo mode real quick, so you can see that I have, this is actually bringing in my Loopback setup. That way I can bring in all audio from different sources, and I also have it set up so that I can bring all my audio coming through Ecamm into Zoom, which doesn't happen natively. You do need something like Loopback. So the beauty of doing it through of like music and sound effects. So for instance, this. Okay, let me. So when I play this, you're also gonna hear my audio. So this is one use case where if I want to be talking and also, hold on, I can't talk while listening to that music because I wanna dance. But if I want to be talking while playing the sound effect from here, then that's one thing because it's all connected together in my audio source. Now, the beauty of something like how I have my dance break set up through Stream Deck and Ecamm, not using the Rodecaster Pro, is that I can mute my audio and still send out audio to you. You guys don't need to hear me heavy breathing while dancing, right? So I prefer to keep certain audio where I'm playing sound effects or music separate from my main audio. So those are things that you got to think about when deciding whether you want to use, you know, Ecamm and Stream Deck for certain things versus Rodecaster Pro. Ducking, I love ducking on the RCP. Daniel, do you, I know, right? Y'all really, you just don't need to hear that. Okay, so, and using Loopback the way I have it? Okay, if somebody wants to come on, oh, that's a very good point. Duh. Okay, what Mike is saying is, yes, all I have to do is hit this button to true. Okay. Good point there. If I had thought about that, I probably would have thought about that. I'm just talking Elma. Okay. Let's see. I like the shot. I didn't want it to be like straight on. Do y'all like it straight on better? Anyway, I thought that was nicer to have it like at an angle, but that's just me. Okay. Let's see. The best part is that I can use all the sound effects and overlays in my virtual cam when I go to other live streams as a guest. Yeah, totally right. Okay, so let me go into demo mode here because I want to show you the software from Rodecaster Pro. So this is how you manage what buttons are playing. So all you have to do, these are like, you see that has laughter, right? That's a laughter button. And these are all the ones that they've put in here. This was some song, an intro, outro kind of song. And so what I did instead was I loaded in the Alter song that you all know so much. There, I know. I actually got a, okay, I have to say this. I actually got a red dustbuster to wipe down my gear, and then I totally forgot to do that this morning. So I've been like, oh, I see dust. Okay, so actually, let me keep that on there. Okay, so in the Rodecaster software, all you have to do is click on that, right click on it, and you can choose the color of the button. So if I change laughter to blue, you'll see that light just changed, right? So pay attention to this button right here, and it'll change with the color that I choose. Now, if I wanted to have different actions, you can play around with these playback styles. And if you hover over each of the piece of the software, it'll show you what it is that it does. So like it's all, currently all of them are on latch, where I just press and press it to stop. Press to play, press to stop. And then they have other options. Like if you want to pause it in the middle of it, you know, things like that. So if you want to export a sound effect to your computer, you would use this button. If you want to import a new, so instead of laughter, all right, here's where we're going to play, okay? If you have questions, guys, be sure to put Q in front of the question. And do we have anybody who's really, really good at the Rodecaster Pro who would like to come on to the interview system and discuss some of this stuff? Completely on the fly here. Okay, so let's do... Okay, I'm never gonna use that one. So let's replace that. And all I'm gonna do is click this button and then choose, hold on. Where was this? Okay, confetti. I just have to find it. I had it pulled up. Confetti. No, darn it, hold on. My confetti. Oops, I don't know how to spell. Confetti music. I just have to find it on this Mac. Oh, come on. That's the name of the folder. There it is. Okay, so what we can do is take a look. I like that one. Let's do that one. Okay, so now it's gonna load in to this button right here. And now it's changed the name of the file to the name of the button. Right? So we can have confetti, we can have a little conquistador music. We can play around with that in a very fun way. So that, I mean, it's super, super simple. That's all you really need to do in order to do that. Now, the thing that I was wondering is, hold on, let me get out of demo mode here. The thing I was wondering is it, I believe it's easy, and I haven't, again, had the chance to play around with this, but I think I can record a clip and load it in at the same time. Or is it, do I have to, like, I know I have to record to the SD card or the micro SD card, and then I can use that as a file that I pull and put into the Rodecaster software. I'm assuming that's how easy it is. Yes, it is super, super fast and easy. It's very easy to set up. It's very easy to use. pinata time, right? Pinata time. Woo, woo. okay, let's see. Okay. Hold on just a second. I am going to open up my interview system and get somebody ready to come in. Okay, so here's the deal. I am going to have you, Callie, put this in chat, but, oh, you have it in, okay. Okay, so if we want to grab India and Matt, those two people have said that they're interested. So those are the only two people who can click that link. Or and then we can have somebody on here to answer some questions as well, because I see a bunch of questions coming in. Don't you love crowdsourcing? Don't you love this community? While I'm just now putting it into my production in a bigger way, we've got people who are really great at it in this community, because this is the beauty of this community. Hold on. I just want to make sure. Yeah. Okay, so we are always, I know, I can change the guest link after the fact, always. And I don't have, hold on, I'm going to have to go into, I think we have two people who are going to join. Daniel, did you want to join or not? I kind of got the feeling that you might, but I didn't see you actually say so. So I'm going to, I need to go. All right, we're just doing things on the fly, y'all. Just doing things on the fly. Hey, hey.
Hi, Laura.
How are you, Matt? From all things YouTube.
Thanks for having me on. Glad you're well. And happy belated birthday.
Thank you. Appreciate it. So while you tell me your favorite thing about the Rodecaster Pro, I'm going to be over here setting some stuff up to bring on India as well. Oh, wait, there's an echo?
Do I have USB mix minus on? Let me check. Nope, I should be good. Is there an echo with me?
I'm not hearing an echo.
Okay.
But everybody is saying that you have an echo on your mic. Is that because of how I said it's set up somehow through the Rodecaster?
You should turn off USB mix minus. Go to advanced audio.
Wait, on what?
On the Rodecaster.
In on the Rodecaster itself, go to advanced,
then audio.
Wait, hold on, let me get this up. Hitting all the buttons. Hold on, why isn't my camera working all of a sudden? Are you kidding me? There we go. Okay, I'm going to Rodecaster, advanced, then audio,
then processing,
processing,
and turn on USB mix minus. Okay. Now I should not be echoing.
All right, everybody, let me know.
Check one, check two. Am I echoing? Test, test, test.
All right. Hello, hello. You are not blue. Let me get that off. This is what happens when you do all on the fly stuff.
That was one of my tips.
You know what? I'm just going to go completely raw here and just not use graphics And I'm going to get India in the house as well. Oh, you know audio from you. Okay, so Matt, that fixed that. So is that something that everybody needs to do? Wait, where did your audio? Oh, how about that's all me? Somehow
yes,
you...
everyone do. Everyone get very familiar with USB Mix Minus. It will save your life, and it's awesome.
So Mix Minus, for explanation purposes, is basically removing that echo. Anyone want to explain that a little bit better?
USB Mix Minus essentially means you're sending that channel out to the stream. So you do not want to send your computer's audio out to the stream because I'm talking through your computer. You only want your microphone to go out to the stream. So with USB Mix Minus enabled, only Laria's microphone is going out and mine isn't.
Is this working?
Yeah. No, that was all my fault, India.
Oh.
When I added you guys, I thought you heard me say that. When I added you guys to the stream, somehow it went into interview mute.
Got it. Got it. Hello, hello, hello.
Hi.
Hey,
so we've got India and Matt. You guys, real quickly, tell everybody who you are, and then we'll dig into some Rodecaster Pro questions and advanced things that you think I should know about the Rodecaster Pro. How does that sound?
Awesome. Yeah.
So India, you
go first. All right. So hey, everyone. I'm India Delgado. I actually got a last minute invite. Dr. Elo, moderator, is watching. I worked with Loria this weekend on some loopback stuff, Rodecaster Pro stuff. And then Dr. Elo said, hey, open invite. And I said, hold on. Anyway, so I do some live streaming. I am a huge fan of Loria and live streaming pros. I've been watching you guys. I'm sure a lot of you guys have seen me in the comments when I'm not working. I am a member. Absolutely. And I am a newer baby live streamer, baby content creator, but I like to do fancy stuff like this so we can have fun on the live stream. And I am the only India Delgado on YouTube, so easy to find me. And I guess that's pretty much it.
I love it. Did you say your channel name? Sorry, I was multitasking.
iDelgado782 is my channel name, but if you search for me under my name, India Delgado, I am the only one that pops up. Yes, thank
you. There you go. She rules. And yes. Matt from All Things YouTube, why don't you intro yourself?
Well, the YouTube channel name is All Things YouTube, and that's where you find me on YouTube. I've been streaming. I have 125 episodes. I stream once a week. I'm going strong. I'm helping people be awesome on YouTube. It's a lot of fun. Go check it out.
I love it. Thank you guys so much. I love bringing community members into the mix, especially when I'm just like... India and India knows this well by now. I tend to like, okay, yes, I can spend an hour going through all of the settings and I can, you know, play it with it and test it. But sometimes, and that's the reason that you guys are here with us as well, sometimes it's more efficient for you to get together with a community of people who know and have experience with a piece of gear that you're just learning. So that's why, you know, people are in our Streamer Accelerator program. That's why they are here in this Live Streaming Pros community to learn and be more efficient about that process. So, but the process is there. We all have to, with a new piece of gear, like dig in, play with it. I promise you're not going to break anything. Well, I can't promise you that. You might, but no. Most people think I'm going
to
break it.
Like
this is going to be bad. This is going to be bad. I don't know what I'm doing. And I would just encourage you to play with all the buttons, hit all the things. Just don't smash it on the ground when you get frustrated. That's the only way you're going
to
break it, right?
Right. Exactly. Don't be the Incredible Hulk.
Settings as well.
That's right. True. Yes, you can always reset to factory settings. Matt, can you bring your audio up a little?
Absolutely. How about
awesome.
That? 1, 2, 3.
Check. Sounds more even. Okay, so what settings? You saw, well, Indy, I don't know if you saw, but I just basically walked people through the basic buttons, what they all are, and how to swap out audio sounds. So what other, outside of Mix Minus, do I need to know? Ducking was something that that Daniel mentioned in chat. So should we start there and then go from there?
I don't have experience with ducking. What about you guys?
Yeah, I'm not worried about ducking is, there's a feature that's automatically turned on if you have multiple people using the XLR microphones, and that is the person on channel one gets the master ducking. In other words, it is more favorable to the person on channel one.
Yeah.
And ducking,
okay, so
ducking is when people
talk over top
of you. Yeah. So whoever's the main, whoever's the host of the podcast gets the most airtime because it will pull the other volume down of your guests. And that's on by default. So you get that right off the gate.
Okay. So it's automatically ducking. But like in Ecamm, I actually turn off that audio processing and that echo cancellation is something that they kind of auto default. But I don't like how it ducks people. And so I actually prefer to keep that off because then you get some awkward like silences and weird that ducking happening. Mm-hmm. So it's on by default with the Rodecaster Pro. So if you don't like that effect, we need to turn that off. And I did see, hold on, let me go. I did see how to actually do that. I'm gonna get zoomed in on here. So we go to settings and then advanced and then audio. And then I think it was in processing again. And there's ducking. Oh, it's not on by default.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think you have to turn that on because that's usually for a podcasting feature that you would want. Yeah.
I've got a
and when that's on, whoever's on channel one gets more powerful ducking features.
More power.
Yep. All the power.
Gloria, can I say something? I mean, there's a selling tip for the Rodecaster Pro that requires no button pushes. And that is the audio processing. The default audio processing is amazing on this.
Yep.
You could buy this device, turn on the default audio processing, and you will sound so much better.
Yes.
I can crank it off.
It makes you sound sexy and sultry. Very enticing.
Watch. I'll turn it off with me. So here is audio processing on. Audio processing off. No audio processing. Now it's on. Now it's on.
You sound like a radio host all of a sudden.
That blows my mind. That alone is worth the investment of this hardware. It is sort of a luxury piece of hardware, but you can't beat that.
Nope. Not at all.
Wait.
And it also has the proprietary.
Yes, of course. I didn't want to do it on the show, but I had to do it in the chat.
You can always do it on the show. It's you.
So I'm from New York, born and raised in Brooklyn. I was trying to show Loria how to do the calling from, you know, when you're in New York, how people say hello. Usually, you know, it's kind of like a holla. So New York, when we see each other, and this is India's like, what is it? Her tag is Yurt was cracking. And so the community who knows me, everybody says Yurt. So I was trying to get Laura to say Yurt.
And I
think you did a good job.
Yurt. Well. Matt, you go. You go. You try.
Do it, Matt. Do it.
Yurt.
There you go. That was good. That was he sees it down the block and we're trying to communicate, but we don't want to call too much attention. So that was good, Matt. I love that. We'll work with Loria on her Yurt.
Wow. Okay, Matt, I totally interrupted you. You were about to say something else.
along with that compressor setting that comes default out of the box, you also have the proprietary AFX processing.
Okay.
And that is, it has a funny name, I'm going to warn you. It has two funny names. There's two flavors. It's the oral exciter. I'm not kidding. That's an industry term. And Big Bottom.
Big Bottom.
Right.
Oral Exciter and Big Bottom.
I saw that earlier. Where am I going for that?
Okay, so go into your channel one. So hit your pink channel one.
Oh, that's right. Okay.
And then go to audio processing. Wait, go out of audio processing.
Oh, there's Big Bottom.
You see it?
And the Oral Exciter. Yeah, right there.
Yeah, well, those are the on-off switches. You can configure those in another screen. But I especially for male voices, big bottom, turn, keep that puppy on. You want that on.
Wait, it's you
on
want by big default. Bottom on?
On, for, on, absolutely.
Especially for male voices, yes. Big bottom on and the oral voices? Exciter on.
No, it's just, I think it's the same thing. I think because I keep them on, and I like the way it makes me sound on mine. I keep them all on, in all honesty, because I'm actually downstairs in the basement. So even with the noise gate, I'm downstairs. I call it in the dungeon. But that eliminates a lot of, like, the vent and, you know, how the heater turns off and on. And if my brother's washing clothes or something, because they don't care that we're live streamers. It's like they have to live real life. But yeah, you can, the noise gate does cancel out those lower ends and it keeps everything sounding all good. So I keep everything turned on. And I think, like I said, it gives me that sexy, sultry voice.
Do I sound better now?
You sound significantly good. Better. And Loria, another part of that processor that you're taking advantage of is it will pull down the loud parts.
Yep.
If there's ever a loud,
you mean like when audio. I get really excited?
Exactly. Right. Or yes. When we do yurt, you know how we do. Yeah.
Yurt.
When you were on the USB mic, there was none of that compression pulling it down.
Yeah.
That one improvement has improved the live streaming pro stream as if it needed to be improved because it's awesome already, but it did. It took it up a notch. It
okay.
did.
Okay. Yep. What say you guys in the chat room? Did you notice a difference? And sometimes, you know, there are certain things for me. I am not an audio person. This is why I bring audio people on the show. There's certain things. You don't have to be great at everything. I'm great at a lot of things when it comes to live streaming. But audio, I don't have an ear for audio. So sometimes I can't quite hear all of those individual things. But yeah, so I'm glad to hear that I sound even better. Oh my God.
I want to talk about,
have
you guys covered using the Rodecaster Pro to get into Clubhouse and to sound extremely amazing? You did? Okay.
I haven't done it yet, but I am working on, I'm testing that probably this weekend. Do you want to do it right now? We could open up a Clubhouse room.
Let's do it. Okay. Come on.
What say y'all in the chat room? This is just getting to be a really interesting stream.
Yes, let's do it. Right, you
I'm
have a TRRS to TRRS cable. Hold on. Let's get your setup first. Right, exactly.
I can't just Come bring on, it in Loria. Via the... Womp, womp. I can't just bring it in via... Hold on. Wrong way. Via this?
No, because you need to connect your phone from Clubhouse into there. And so to get the best sound and to get one for you to hear it through your headphones or through your speakers, right, you want to connect your phone with the adapter, right? So you need two things. You need your iPhone adapter, your, what is it, the little headphone adapter, thingy, right? And then you need a TRRS to TRRS cable. It has to be on both ends, right, Matt, right? So we need that one, okay?
Yep.
Then you need to get a TRRS to TRRS cable on each end. So that's the one with the three rings. Go ahead, Loria.
No, that's what I was about to say. I was just about to point out the two versus three rings.
Yep, so that's the one, and it has to have the three rings on each end, okay? And so what you do is with the adapter and your TRRS to your TRRS cable, one goes in your iPhone on here. Then on the back of the Rodecaster Pro, you put it in the headphone jack or the picture of the phone on the back of the Rodecaster. And then you'll bring your audio in and out. You can use your great microphone. You'll hear it either on the headphones or the speakers. And then the only other thing that you want to know, if like people who already have the tools want to try that right now, is whenever you connect a microphone to your cell phone in Clubhouse, you're going to see a green box pop up on top. And on the very top, it's going to say talking only mode or music only mode. In order for this to function properly, you need to make sure that it's music mode. So it's weird, right? Because you're not doing music. But in order for the Rodecaster to let you hear or Clubhouse to send the audio out to the Rodecaster and receive audio in from the Rodecaster, you do have to select your music only mode, and then it works flawlessly and you sound like you're a boss on Clubhouse.
Okay, so we are going to be doing a full video about the tech of going both ways with Clubhouse, bringing Clubhouse into your live stream so you could have like an audio conversation, or alternatively bringing your stream into Clubhouse. So the whole like tech setup of that, we are going to have like an in-depth discussion about, but that just gave you what the information you need is to do that one way. There is something, something is going on. Do you guys still hear like background noise or a Mac fan or something? I'm not hearing it right now, but
no,
it was.
I don't hear. I didn't catch anything. I'll raise my volume a little bit. I haven't caught anything.
My fan is going. I can.
Oh, I hear that. Yeah.
There okay, that's what I was hearing. Yeah. Okay.
Yep.
I'm boss already.
Boss. She's a boss.
I have another tip.
Yes.
Okay, so the USB Mix Minus we were playing with, it's really your best friend, because I had a situation where I had a guest on Ecamm, and you don't use the computer audio. Make a note, because you don't need that feature. There's a feature in Ecamm where you install something and then the computer audio. You don't need it with the Rodecaster Pro. And right. With USB Mix Minus, you can have your guest hidden. Like, you don't need to show the scene with you and the guest. It could just be you. And your guest could be talking to you. You could hear the guest, and the guest will not go out onto the stream. So instead of muting the guest completely, the guest could be in the green room, essentially, and say, oh, Matt, did you see that comment from so-and-so? You should reply to that. No one's going to hear it except for you, and you can do that with the Rodecaster Pro. That's pretty advanced. It's subtle, but it's advanced.
Now,
so.
Ecamm did release back channel audio recently. So that now works natively within Ecamm, but that is great to know about the Rodecaster Pro as well. That way you could have a little bit more control over it, possibly if you set it up that way. So how would you set that up if somebody wanted to do so?
Just like you did the first thing when I got on,
you would toggle
USB Mix Minus on and off. Okay. And when USB Mix Minus is in one state, everyone can hear your guest. And then when it's in the other state, only you can hear the guest.
Yeah.
That's advanced audio routing.
Yep. Yeah, exactly. That's why it took, Ecamm a little bit to add that feature, is because it is... I can't imagine the engineer's maps in order to make that stuff happen. You know what I mean?
Jeff okay. Boot says that only works if you are monitoring through the Rodecaster.
Yes.
And that's what I recommend. Yes.
Right.
You can abandon all of Ecamm's guest audio bells and whistles and just use the Rodecaster.
Right.
Yeah.
So, and I am now monitoring through the Rodecaster Pro. So this is also probably another benefit. If you're doing audio monitoring through Ecamm, I do notice a little bit of a slight delay. Do you notice that as well, India?
If you're monitoring, yes.
Yeah, through Ecamm.
So what, like your audio? Because I had to put in a mic delay for four
delay.
Seconds on
exactly.
my setup. Yep, I put on, yeah. So I have, and it also depends on your capture card. So
right.
with my entire setup, I have the A6400, the Elgato capture card, and then the Rodecaster. And I've found that a 4 second mic delay is what works best for me and my setup.
Yeah, and everybody's going to be different on that.
Right.
But with the Rodecaster Pro, I am now hearing myself with zero delay. That way I can hear if
right.
I need to, lower or raise my volume and how far I need to do that. So
yep.
that's a big benefit of Rodecaster Pro as well, so they don't have to mess with the delay itself. So we have a bunch of questions, and then we'll come back to any other tips that you guys might have. Christopher is now trading in the L8
yes.
for a Rodecaster. I'm sold.
Yes, do it. Exactly.
and I saw some people asking for a link in the description, so you guys are covered from that. You don't have to really go searching for it. Answered Jeff's question about monitoring. Jim, does the Rodecaster allow you to alter your voice? Unfortunately, not.
No.
It's not like the Go XLR where you can do the voice changers.
Right.
Is there anything you guys use for that?
No, I don't. I mean, as much as I wanted to do it, it was like with everything else that you get for the Rodecaster, and like with what Matt said, that's what sold me, was the audio processing where it's in the box. I didn't have to worry about, because now I don't even have to do audio processing for post edits. It just, it sounds great out the box live and you're good to go. So I kind of said, okay, I guess I'll live without the cool sound effects or the voice effects. Did you guys go over noise pads and adding in your sound effects and things like that, the little pad buttons? Because I know I came in late. Okay, cool.
Yeah. You know, in this community, when you come in late, you're supposed to bring cookies for everybody. And right now that's 124 people. So do you have 124 cookies, India?
They're baking in the oven right now.
Okay, we'll wait.
I don't know how long it'll take.
What were you about to say, Matt?
Oh, if I had to choose between the Oral Exciter and Big Bottom giving me this radio voice or funny sound voice changers, I would choose what the Rodecaster gives you. 1,000%. I would choose that Big Bottom any day.
1,000%.
And I'm too busy delivering value. I'm delivering hardcore value. Really? I don't have time for high-pitched voices.
I hear that. Good. Okay.
I shouldn't say that. I do like the voices.
Everybody has their own thing, right?
The voices are fun. I admit,
they're
fun.
The voices are fun, yes. Okay. So, yes, you guys are hearing Matt's mic or the fan from his computer. So that's what that is. I did have him raise his audio, so that's probably why. Okay. Also, we're going to keep answering questions, but who has questions suggestions for my noise pad? Like, I've got the noise pad right here waiting. I zoomed in. Waiting for the right sound effects. And I've got Epidemic Sound up to try and find some stuff. So this is, I'm never going to use.
I'm a big fan of the George Takei. Oh my.
Oh my. That's a good one.
Yeah.
What do you use, India?
So I have, of course, my, because, you know, going back to New York, my, the air horn that we get, and Ecamm has that as well, but I did load that on there. I loaded the, when someone gets in trouble, we have to let them know. We're going to put them in timeout.
Hey, I need a cookies thing then.
Exactly.
Where the cookies?
And then, wait, Cookie Monster.
There has to be a Cookie Monster sound effect.
Exactly. Right. definitely you need a ding, ding, ding. Because, right, when someone gives you some sort of great, you have to make sure that you say, that is an amazing point.
Yes.
So having some of your ding, ding, dings on there. And then, again, if another good point, or you know how sometimes when people, you have guests or you go off on a rant and you're trying to prove a point, well, the judge has spoken. You want to make sure, emphasize it in, right? The judge has spoken. I loaded in a few. And then, again, going back to New York, usually, so it's so funny, Keith Pelzer pointed out to me that if I'm doing tutorials, I usually say, so boom, a lot. Yeah. That's a New York thing, boom. So boom.
I feel
so
like you could get a better boom.
How about this one? I got to keep looking.
That's a pretty good one. I was thinking more like, you know that gif of Anna somebody.
Yeah. Anna Kendrick.
Like,
Anna,
boom. Yes.
Boom. Yes. Boom. I got to look it up. Okay. Boom. Right.
Boom.
Right. Yes. All right. So I'll keep on. I'll loading. And then just some other ones that I put were kind of, you know, I forgot to bring everyone cookies. So where are we?
Was the rim shot on by default? I can't remember, but that's, you got to have that.
Of course. Right, I think exactly.
We all hit them at the same time.
We got a lot of rim shot there. Abby, yes, an Abby Bark. I totally need an Abby Bark on here.
Yes.
That's a great one. Yes. And you guys, this is a perfect opportunity for you to, there goes my praying mantis. this is the perfect opportunity to add personality to your streams, right? So when you do level up with gear, it gives you the opportunity to put your personality behind it, right? You can use this default sound effects. Oh, that's not the sound. That's not a default.
I like that.
That's mine.
I like that.
It's for the confetti.
Oh, that's cool.
That's from Epidemic Sound. 30-day free trial. Link in the description. Oops, I didn't mean to hit it again. I just got a little tap happy. but yeah, so like take this as an opportunity when you have devices like this to really dig in and create audience triggers, right? So with the boom, with India, you know, that's an audience trigger. For Matt, that would be a total audience trigger for him with the George Takei sound effect because he is a total geek. And, you know, so these are the things that you got to think about. What makes you you? And boom, you just assign it to the button and there you go.
That's it.
Okay, so some more questions. Diana, you've been mentioned. Diana Gladney has been in here talking, and I meant to say this earlier. And do you want to join? We can get you a link to join, Diana, if you would like to come up as well. So, questions. Does the Rodecaster come with a mic? No. Who has a sad sound effect?
Oh, I got it. Hold on.
I got to put that one in.
Oh, right. No, I'm sorry.
See, they just came out so with a mic
for $100.
Right. Exactly.
The pod mic is what it's called?
The Rode pod mic? The pod mic is $100. Absolutely. Yeah, you can get some good ones for $100, $150. Yep.
I have the Heil PR40, but.
Where's the unicorn pinata? yes. Oh, you're already on here. Okay. Sad trombone. Scott wants the sadtrombone.com. Okay. I'll have to download that one.
Yeah.
It better be amazing for $600.
Right.
And this is one of those level four pieces of gear, guys. This isn't for everybody, but.
Yeah. It is. And, you know, so it's so funny. And then as I started, for me, I think what sold it was, again, we already said the noise processing. You know, I think things are a little bit different now, of course, because of COVID. But remember, like before COVID, if you travel, you can get four people on, you can call someone, you can bring it on, right? So your plethora of inputs. And then for me, what really I said, oh, I'm going to get the most bang for my buck was when I connected the phone to the Rodecaster for Clubhouse, because now that's a whole nother avenue. And then depending on your audience, I know that of course Clubhouse has the, you know, you have to get permission from the people that you're recording. But if you have that, if you're in a group, like if it's me, Loria, Diana, Dak, Matt, right? And we all agree that we're okay with recording and we're giving some great content, you can now record that directly to the SD card, right? And bring in audio and have a different form of content creation just with the Rodecaster. So as you start to get more creative and start to see, you know, the value on it, you'll get the return on your investment for the $600 in no time. Promise you that. If not, I'll make you some cookies personally.
Hey, you heard it here. Somebody record that.
I could talk about a few advanced things which will apply to streamers and content creators. The Rodecaster Pro has the ability to record all tracks in one recording, like ready to post, or a file format where the tracks are separate. So you could go into post and pull down that talkative co-host or interviewee that's rambling when they're not supposed to. So that's one option that you have. And that's powerful. And you can do flags as well.
For the recording itself is what you're saying. So for like if you're doing this with a podcast or you're wanting to repurpose content.
You can slap a button and it'll put a little flag in the audio file. So when you bring it into your audio software, you can see those markers.
Oh,
so if you have
that?
Like, I'll have to look it up. I haven't had a need to do it yet. I just launched a podcast,
You have to be recording when you're doing it. And then when you're, so you hit the recording button and as you're recording to the SD card, it'll show up a little flag on the top of the screen. So if you want to do a marker to remember that particular area that you say, okay, they said some gems and some great content, you hit the little flag on the screen and then that'll give you a marker to remember to go back to it.
Yeah.
So this one right here, this green.
Yeah, press the big record button that's green.
It's
big
recording.
Big plastic button.
Yep.
Oh, it's red now? Oh, yeah.
It's blue now.
Then there's a way, Mine has a little flag.
Oh, I don't have an SD card in it. Right. Oh, you got to put an SD card. Right, because you're going to record directly to the SD card. So you have to put one in there. So that's another recommendation and another pro tip, right? You know, as cheap as SD cards are, just have one on there because you never know that one moment you want to record and now you don't have to be connected to the computer. The Rodecaster is a standalone unit. So if you have an SD card on there, make sure you put it on there, hit record, and you are good to go.
Yeah, and I thought I had one here and I couldn't find it before we started. So I was like, no, it's a micro SD, not a mini SD card, SD. Guys.
Right. And don't eject the card and then bring it over to your computer. There's a way that you can turn your Rodecaster Pro into a mounted hard drive on your computer and just transfer it over the already connected USB cable.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. And so, in the setup, I love Rode.
I know
packaging.
They're big cards.
I know it's like massive. Hold on, I'm gonna.
It took forever for mine to arrive because it was in the middle of.
I'm gonna show this to you, but like they show you how to connect your computer and everything. It's really really simple, guys. But they have all of these like cards where they walk you through what everything is. Okay, let me get you guys back on. There we go.
it's like they put every feature that needed to be there front and center with big buttons, and everything that doesn't need to be there, they put it on a sub menu. It's brilliantly laid out. The UI is brilliant. Kudos. Yep. It's a modern piece of equipment for sure.
And then Michael in the community also said a lot of people, and that's true because I've reminded them, there's a headphone jack. So there's your headphone jacks in the back of the unit, which are quarter inch headphone adapters, right? But then there is a headphone jack on the very bottom of the unit on the front, right below the pads, the sound pads. And that's where I connect mine. I don't have my cable going directly to the back. I have it on the bottom, and that controls volume number one is what it controls. Yep, so there's one in the back, and then there's one on the bottom. And a lot of people miss that one.
And why do you use this one instead of that one?
Because I just wanted it on the bottom. Just for easier access. That's all it is, really, just for easier access. Matt, what were you going to say?
I have both connected because sometimes I want to hear these.
Right, you can have,
I put these on.
Perfect.
Yep. And when I want my earbuds, but so I have the one in the front with my earbuds and the one in the back, these. Yep. And it's the same channel. It's the number one channel.
Okay, but there was a reason. I was using the one in the front, and then India, when you and I were talking before, is that you told me to go ahead and plug it into the back. What was the scenario that we decided to change that? Remember?
I don't think there's a difference.
About Zoom? I don't know. No, I think because you had two pairs of headphones. Because remember, you had your big headphones. That's all it was. The same thing what Matt said. Yep. You had your big headphones, and then you were trying to listen, I think, through the little headphones. And I said, no, don't unplug. And we just did. Matt just explained. Matt, were you spying on us this Saturday?
Matt.
I think you were spying on us. Hold on.
All geeks think alike. Come on.
Right, exactly. That was perfect.
By the way, did you like my nice Vanna White?
I know that was great. No, that was perfect. That was a perfect shot. And as I spoke and as Matt spoke, you just did the whole, I love it. Perfect. Great. You're hired.
Thanks. Ding, ding, ding.
Buffered. And then it kept on.
I just went go live again.
Okay. So it should load back up in a minute.
Okay. Let's see. Are we back, guys? Did y'all have a hiccup? Yes. Great guess. I don't know where Diana is. I think she was going to join. But
she is going to join. I know she. Let me see. I know she said she was going to just wrap up some stuff. So
oh, got it. Okay, no worries. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Now was buffering. Okay, we're good. Yep. We didn't even lose our link. That's fantastic. Okay, so let's keep going with more questions. Sorry about that. I got a notification that the stream stopped. I didn't even go near the stream deck, by the way, guys.
No. So that happened to me last weekend, and this is how I justified my Mac, my M1 Mini, Loria. That was it. Because what happened was I did two live streams last week, and it kept doing that. And I was like, this MacBook Pro and fans, and that's it. I'm justifying the stream. And now you're kind of messing up my justification.
Yeah, so seriously, because I have a really good iMac.
Don't say that again.
Laurie, at the top of the hour, I have to turn into a pumpkin. So
okay, yeah, totally. Okay, well then, cool. Anything else you want to impart your wisdom on before I keep answering questions?
Update the firmware right away and just use the default processor settings with the automatic Big Bottom and Oral Exciter, and you've paid for the unit right there. Everything 1, else is gravy on top of it. Thank you for having me on. I appreciate it.
Yeah, I'm so glad to have you.
I'll hang out for a minute or two.
Okay, but tell everybody what your channel is.
Oh, All Things YouTube. You can find me on YouTube and allthingsyoutube.com. You can go there as well. See, I've got this right there. Boom.
Boom.
Boom. Hold on. Let me get to it. Let me help you out. Boom. We got to plan that better next time, Matt, so I can be prepared. Boom.
These impromptu guest interviews, you know.
Yes.
Everybody's exactly. loving you guys. Thank you so much for being so willing to hop on at last minute.
Of course.
Okay, so another question. Wait, I'm trying to figure out. I feel like we're getting questions that aren't have anything to do with this. let's see. Are you on Ecamm beta or regular? Because I love the favorite commons. Yeah, I use the beta. I'm always on beta. But if you can't deal with things going wrong with any software, don't use the beta. Like, you got to be willing to have a little hiccup here and there.
Yep.
Oh, good. They're learning a lot. Yeah, they're loving you guys. Awesome. Don says, why can I not be able to bring somebody on Facebook Live when I have been able to before? Oh, that's, you guys, we're talking about the Rodecaster Pro today. I do open Q&As on Fridays, by the way. So if you're having trouble with Facebook Live and interviews maybe from the phone, I think is probably what you're talking about, or from Creator Studio, it could just be a Facebook bug because Facebook loves their bugs. They love their bugs. So sometimes something will work one day and not the other day. So give it a couple of days and see if it works again. If not, move to a software like Ecamm for Mac or vMix for PC. That's what we train you how to use around here so that you can have more control and not rely on Facebook. Okay. Greg.
Laura, India, I'm going to jump off. Streamers, you're awesome. Take care.
Nice meeting you, Matt.
Thanks, Matt.
Yes,
bye.
Nice meeting you, too. Bye.
All right, we're just going to go to the two. Hang tight. Yep. Now you're India. You've added two exclamation points to your name.
Yes, I do. I always do that. I don't know. Good catch. Yes, I do.
India. Exclamation point. Exclamation
India.
Point.
Exactly. Exciting.
Ben just found this channel and loving all the gems that you're dropping. Blessings. Thank you, Ben. Thank you so much for being here and for participating. I appreciate you.
Wrong one.
Did you just
pour a drink?
I
did. I opened the bottle. I ordered a bottle of champagne for us. It was supposed to be.
I'll take a bottle of champagne.
Right? Hello. What time is it over there?
It's 11. It's close to noon.
Oh, mimosas. I mean, that's perfect. There you go.
Greg says, can you use the USB Bluetooth option to bring a phone into a Zoom call?
Yes. Yes. So phone call into a Zoom call. So USB. So yeah, as long as on Zoom, you know, you can choose your microphone, you're going to make sure the Rodecaster Pro is chosen. And then yes, the only thing that I don't think would happen, right, is the other way around where your Zoom community would be able to hear. No, the other way around, sorry, where the phone call will be able to hear your Zoom participants. So you want to be mindful of that. But that's what Laura, so depending on if they have to be on the phone, if not, if you can get them to come in as a guest, because if you have them come in as a guest through Ecamm using Loopback, then it can be two-way. Because remember, kind of like Matt said it once, you can do it where, like, Laura can be full screen, I call her, or, you know, through Ecamm interview mode. So if the guest doesn't want to be on camera, just have them come in that way and then set up Loopback, and then it'll be that two-way communication. That's the way I would recommend it for now, if that made sense. And it's Queen Diana. What is going on, Diana?
Whoa. Wait, hold on.
It looks, sounds like audio. You're a computer audio, Diana. Yeah. I know. We all had problems today. Today is not the day.
Hey, that's, you know, it happens.
You should be hearing me because I know I picked the Rodecaster Pro, which is what I use. So is that coming through now?
Uh-uh.
No. You might have to log out and log back in. Who did that? Somebody.
Try popping back out.
Okay. Let me switch and hit back out.
Nice. Christopher is going to get his Rodecaster Pro.
By the way,
Tag has brought the phone call into Zoom on the RCP. So there was a question. I did not see your question, Jeriel, about the PodTrack P8. So did you put a Q in front of your question? You have to put a Q in front of your question in order for it to make its way to me. That's just the way we do things around here, because our team is gathering up questions and putting them over here for me, so that if I don't catch it over here, I at least catch it over there. So cue in front of the question. How are we sounded?
So everything on my end says Rodecaster Pro.
Beautiful.
All good.
Okay. All righty. All good. Getting questionable there for a moment.
So Diana, introduce yourself. Let everybody know who you are, and we'll keep answering questions, and maybe you have some tips on the Rodecaster.
Sure. So my name is Diana Gladney. I have my Diana Gladney YouTube channel. I help entrepreneurs simplify video creation process so that they can get back to the business of why you started your company. So we go over cameras and tech and things similar to like LSP, not just live streaming, but more so just video centric as well. And so, yeah, so that's, I'm super pumped to be here.
And I have to say, these two women are just full of gold and drop knowledge bombs. Every time they're on, or I'm on a stream with them. So you guys pay attention to them. I love these two women. Thank you for
being
here.
Hold on,
wait, let me go back.
Oh, it's a pleasure. Do you have the all? I was about to say, where's your all sound effect? I don't have one.
I got it.
You know what you need? India is like, you know, that cartoon effect, you know, the cartoon where the heart comes out.
Yeah, like a thumping heart. Oh my God. I need to go write down. Yeah. I need to go, now I'm gonna start writing down on my trusty iPad.
You need to change there you go. This.
Yes. Yeah. All right, I'm on there it. Writing it down.
How about give us 15 minutes after the stream? She'll send you a message back saying, "Hey, guess what I have?"
Exactly. Diana knows
Guess what I have? Hey guys, look what I can do.
Oh, I love it.
But that's like the genius of India, honestly. I was on the stream, I was in the chat. She said she was on today, and I was like, sweet. So I was in the chat supporting her. And that's one of the things I love about India is like how technologically savvy that she is, and she will stay on it continuously until she gets it sorted out, and then it's like, okay, let's test. And so India's brilliant when it comes to like tech and software, especially when it comes to like the mobile thing. So I'm super pumped to even see her on the show. So I was just wanting to show some love for India.
Oh,
thank you. Now I really need the boom boom.
Boom, boom. The we'll boom, do that. Boom. The boom boom. That's how you label it. Boom boom.
Boom boom. Boom. Exactly.
Yes, exactly. That's the one I was thinking of. Bugs Bunny Bugs Bunny.
Yeah.
Okay. So, next question from Iman: is there a setting or something to look for when multi-track recording with the Podcaster? When I uploaded the tracks to my iMac, there were some channels that peak badly and make the track unusable. So for the individual tracks.
Yeah, it has the multi-track function on there. I'm not sure how much, I haven't had need of really using that. But one of the things that I think if you're going to use multi-track to enable is so that you can see the meters. And you'll see like the numbers, so you know you're not just looking for it to change from green to like orange and red and so forth. You can actually see the numbers, and that's what I go by, is setting like the meter, studio meter, so you can actually know the numerical value so that nobody is peaking.
Yep.
Is that something that you can walk me through showing me on the Rodecaster here?
She has her Diana White. What is it? Vanna White. She's ready. I was putting the names together. Yeah, I was like, wait, what?
And don't make me laugh.
Well, that's the purpose. I got to make everybody laugh. That's what I come in and make people do. Come on now.
I cannot work under these conditions. Okay, let me.
But you can.
Oh my goodness. Wait. Okay.
Hey, you two swapped versus somehow.
Did we?
Yeah. Oh, that's because I was using a different.
Alrighty. Broadcast meters. Okay, so let me back up and then I'll walk you back through how I got to there. So when you click on the settings gear for your Rodecaster Pro,
I have to do this left-handed so my hand doesn't get in the way.
Okay. And so when you see advanced, and then you want to click on audio, From there, you want to click on operations. And at the bottom, you'll see broadcast meters. When you enable that feature, and like if you just hit the home button, you'll now see that you have numbers next to your meters. And what that will do is as we're talking or as that audio is coming in, the way I keep it safe for just about everybody is to get them up to that 15, which should be about 15 decibels or negative 15 decibels, to be honest. That way, as it's getting louder and louder, I don't ever want it to go past a certain point. Mm-hmm. Audio engineer folks will probably have different things of what they say.
Right.
But I know from what by the time I transfer audio files to the computer and maybe you add additional processing if you need it, having those meters just gives me a safe zone to always shoot for.
What were our names again? That's okay.
One of you was D and one of you was Pelpina.
Okay. Let's rock this for a while.
Exactly.
I get to be D Nimmin. Listen.
Yeah, that's
perfect. Let me tell you. My name is D Nimmin. I have a YouTube channel. Go to youtube.com/
Mike is mentioning turn on the compressor on each mic too to help it keep from clipping.
Very true.
Iman says, I switched my meters to the dB levels and I thought I made sure nothing was peaking when recording. I'll have to run another test to make sure I'm doing it right. So
One thing I found is to make sure your headphone volume level is comparable to where you need to accurately monitor, because sometimes you'll have it down where it's too low and you'll be adjusting audio thinking you're raising everybody to a safe point that it's okay. And I'd rather for it to be too low or lower than what I think than for it to be too high, because where you have yours, Luria, that's where I have mine.
Okay.
And that way, you know, I bring people in and test with different voices, very low, you know, just baritone style voices, very high end voices that have different registers in their voices, or someone like me, this more mid-tone kind of a levels, and really just try to dial it in for that specific person as best as you can. But the headphone volume level, having it set at about where you have it, where I have it, I believe India has hers at that same level as well, somewhere thereabout. Mm-hmm. Yep. It helps you to really make sure you're adjusting audio levels as accurately as you can. And, you know, not adjusting for the headphones if it's too bassy or like, so you really got to be careful about the monitoring side of it too. That can really mess you up.
Let's talk about that, because Jim has been asking this question. He asked it in my Streamer Accelerator group this morning and really wants to understand in detail. So let's get geeky. Like you just kind of talked about that, but let's go even further if we can. Like how do we monitor, make sure that final mix, like when Diana came on, everybody was like, well, Diana's louder than, you know, myself and India. So I turned her down over on the Ecamm interview side. Sometimes you can ask the guests to change their levels. But as you're monitoring on this Rodecaster Pro, what exactly, like we talked about the levels here and here and getting, you know, to be able to see up to the 15. But it more fine-tuned controls, because this is only, like, we're only seeing the group as a whole, right? So how do we go deeper?
So I don't know if you've had the occasion to work with the effects preset on there, but we go back into the same kind of area where we just were, where you go into operations through the audio and then operations. Okay. But before you go to operations, if you go back one, there's one that says processing. And in processing, it has what's called effects edit mode. Now, if you're more of a tactile kind of ish person like me, you really want a keyboard, a mouse to fine tune things, I suggest making these changes on a computer. Rode has the Rode Companion app that will, when you change this and you turn this on, if we go back and we hit the back button, and now if we go to where we see audio.
Sorry, guys, I didn't realize that. Hold on.
Oh, it's okay.
Okay.
All right, so let's go.
Audio?
Yeah, and then we're going to go back one more time. All right, and so we now have the ability to, I'm trying to figure out where, I think it is advanced audio. Let me make sure. Because once you turn on the effects audio mode, it's a little bit easier. Probably just click on your microphone number, the number one where you have it, and that'll just kind of shortcut you. Now click to audio processing. Oh. Yep. You'll see stuff you haven't seen before.
Right.
And this will let you be able to really fine tune the high pass filter, the noise gate, the de-esser, the compressor, this affix that gets into like the aural exciter details and stuff. And you can really, like, if you know what you're doing from an audio perspective, really adjust this and fine tune all of these different details versus just turning them on and off. It makes a huge difference. So when you look at things like a high pass filter, that's going to let more of your voice and those more or less the higher tone registers, reason why it's at 60 hertz is that's just the default. Some people may find, like, if you even watch Rhodes video, they talk about that particular gentleman being at about 90 hertz. And that's just to get anything high, like your voice, any of our voices, somewhere they're about to pass through. Anything lower than that, refrigerator noises. The MacBook Pro fans is probably going to call that into question. Yeah. Because that's kind of up there. But anything that low rumble-ish kind of a noise, the higher you increase that high pass filter without adjusting your, you know, your voice to where it's augmented weirdly, will let those higher noises or your voice kind of pass through and kind of cancel out those things. So if you really need to fine tune per person, per microphone, per kind of a thing, and you can lock in and save presets in that Rode Companion app, which is super neat. So like I said, it's getting super geeky at this point, but this is where you can really say, like, okay, read this block of text and just read it long enough and really fine tune it so that when you're monitoring for that person, especially if you have a regular and consistent podcast, you can go deep using these different settings. And like I said, I like to do it on the computer using the Rode Companion app so I can actually see, because the slider, the touchscreen is good on the Rodecaster Pro. It's just not as precise as the mouse. So I just prefer to do it on the Companion app, and that makes it super duper easy.
In the Companion app, though, are you able to separate out the two guests' audio?
Because, or the, like, for the multi-channel?
Yeah, like, and fine-tune that the leveling there, because, like, on the Rodecaster Pro, this is, I mean, this one right here is just the single source of all guests. So are we able to separate that out before
so
we go
I
live?
Have to... I haven't picked into a ton of it, but you can adjust what's called the gain, and that will help more than just, is it loud or soft, that like the main meter. So that way you can go in per microphone, per guest, per person, adjust the gain for the loudness for them specifically. Now that's if they're hooked in. If they're just coming in as a guest through Ecamm, for example, then we really want to have them adjust their main volumes for whatever it is that they're using to something that's more conducive. Or like you said, if I came in a little too loud for your settings, for your setup, then you can make that micro adjustment there when it comes to the Ecamm Live. But, you know, that's the weird thing. It's like they have to have some kind of a know-how or have to be able to make some, you kind of meet you halfway somewhere with it. But I don't think there's any way to really specifically, not that I found, and I could be wrong, not that I found, where you could go in and adjust it, like, and say, you know, and dial in their stuff.
And I will say this, Jim, what I do is you'll see, like, India is coming in full blast, but Diana came, I have her down a little bit because she was coming in too loud. And so usually before we go live, I'll do a test where I say, all right, everybody talk at the same time. Now, this was a was an impromptu, you know.
Right, one of those words. It's one of those things.
That's two in it. We didn't have a chance to do any of those tests, but I will have us all talk, and I'll be monitoring at the same time and listen, and India, like, is coming in a little low, for instance. So I would either have her bring her audio up on her end if she knew how to do that, which she does, but, like, you know, what Diana was saying is not everybody knows what they're doing with that. Or maybe they don't have a mic that is adjustable very much. So, you know, you can control it from here as well in the Ecamm interview system, or if you're using vMix, same thing. But that testing and the monitoring, even if you need to have everybody talk at once, have everybody talk individually, and record a quick test and then listen back to it before you go live. Sorry, that's covering you up. Joanna, thank you for the $2 super chat for the ladies in the house.
I just know the notice Abby, and I'm like, I don't have a dog over here. What's going on? Hey, it makes you smile. I'm all right with that.
It does. Right, exactly.
Yeah. Stephanie Lou was in here petting the Abby Super Chats one time.
Oh, there you go. Yeah.
Okay, if guests come in through the same source, then no. If you have one via USB and one via Bluetooth or TRRS, you could control them separately. Mm-hmm. True, yeah.
Yeah, because if somebody is just completely peaking on their end, you have to get them to adjust, and some of that again is just taking that extra time, like you mentioned, Lori, ahead of the stream to, you know, say, okay, like, this isn't normal, we shouldn't be sounding like this, and so just training them to know what peaking sounds like, because that's a foreign word to them. They're like, peaking, what does that mean? So just that simple education, and like, okay, you know how it's like, it's a buzzing when you get really loud, it gets kind of distorted, we shouldn't sound like that, there's no way to repair that, so we need you to bring your audio down. And even like using the screen share functions and stuff like that in Ecamm, if you're using that, and letting them share their screen and you walk them through even maybe how to change their audio settings. If they're using just like a USB microphone in their computer, can be super duper helpful.
Does that help, Jim? Let me know. And if not, like, I know that there's a lot to it, right? It depends on your setup. It depends on the gear you're using. It depends on the mics. It depends on the guests.
Right.
So perhaps, Jim, we should... perhaps we should even do a full deep dive on that inside of Streamer Accelerator. So I'll look into that. But yeah, okay.
And there were some questions. There's, sorry, Lori. I know that there were some people, because Diana's, and people always get comments on Diana's audio and her setup, especially for the SM7B, because that is a very complicated.
Yeah, I haven't.
So I made a promise to Ricardo that I would point out the question to you, because they want to know, how do you sound so crispy?
Well, you have to have $50. Okay, white chocolate. You're going to buy some coffee.
Hello, the white chocolate.
You want to get a nice coffee mug, okay?
Right.
So, I mean, how geeky, Gloria, you tell me, how geeky do you want to go here?
Well, how about we give them a little teaser, and then how about we invite you back on for a whole video all about just that?
Alrighty. Consider it done.
Okay.
Yeah.
Teaser.
So with the Rodecaster Pro and the Shure SM7B, there is one thing that marries these two together to help you get, so I can be backed up a little bit from the microphone, and that's going to be the FET head. A lot of people talk about using the Cloud Lifter, but that...
Abby! Is it Abby's over here? Where's Abby? Let me just make sure I get it.
Hello, Abby. Hey, Abby. Hello, Abby. Hello.
Thank you, Einar, for the super chat.
That's so awesome. So, goodness, where was I?
I don't even something about that.
So, to marry the Shure SM7B and the Rodecaster Pro, yes, the Shure SM7B does not need what's... But it definitely does help. So I think it's highly recommended. And if you asked us, I would say we're going to recommend it to you. A lot of people refer to the Cloud Lifter. I don't like that because I prefer very simple, clean setups when possible. That requires a second XLR cable, this additional box. You probably got to mount it under the desk. I don't want to do all that. The FET head is just about this big.
Yeah.
And it connects to the Rodecaster Pro in the back, so it doesn't have to complicate the setup or anything. And that raises the gain so that you can hear me clearly. The other thing is that the Shure SM7B on the back, you'll notice that it has these little switches. You can use just like the pin cap or something, and you can adjust those. More details on that later. But you can adjust those for your voice, and I think it's important to do testing for that. I do have effects dialed in on the Rodecaster Pro for my audio. But it's just to let you know where that meter is sitting, that level, because a lot of people do ask. That solid white line on the Rodecaster Pro called Unity, I am about 1.5 up from there. So just a little about halfway between the Unity line and that next line up. And most people, if you see their slider way, way up on the Rodecaster Pro and they're using the Shure SM7B or something similar, they do not use a preamp or a clout lifter or something that increases the gain but lowers the noise floor. So you can hear me clearly. You don't hear any background noise or any rumblings or what have you. Or if you're trying to hide the fact that you have children in the other room, this is great for that as well. And so I do have processing on if you want me to run through like the basic of what is on. Everything is on but the aural exciter. All right, that came in perfectly. It gave me perfect timing. You're muted, Laurie.
You're muted. Yeah, Laurie, you're muted. What happened?
I was multitasking. I was getting like speed notifications saying my internet connection sucked. So I was over there trying to fix things. I was saying thank you, Marcus, for the super sticker. Okay, yeah. A quick overview of maybe your settings. Do you have a behind the scenes camera? Do you want to go full screen or what?
No, because I clicked on the link, so I'm sorry. I didn't do the
totally fine.
Somebody else asked me about this, so I promised that I would do a video. So I recorded it. It just has been edited to upload to the channel, but we can definitely come back and do a deep dive over here on LSP as well for sure.
Yeah, because we've gone 20 minutes past the hour, which is amazing. Everybody's loving the stream, and you guys have rocked it. So thank you. We have a lot of questions we did not answer. So here's my promise to you guys watching. First of all, you love the fact that I've brought on community members and peers and friends. So we'll do that a lot more. But also... all the questions that we didn't get to, we're gonna just do more Roadcaster Pro videos.
I think you opened up a box here.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
I'm looking and at all these questions. I'm like, we'll be here for 4 hours.
Exactly. Well, yeah, that's what they're trying to get you. That's what I said. You don't know me. And remember, didn't we tell you on Saturday, the 5 hour energy,
five hour
energy live stream. They're trying to pull you in. This is what happens with the community. They try to reel you in. And then, you know, like the three of us, all of us, right, in our group, we're all such giving people. We want to give back to the community. And I know Loria talks about that all the time, where you have to engage with your audience. Yeah. But you see, y'all do it to us. This is the problem. Y'all do it to us because we engage with y'all. And then the next thing we know, we're looking up at Ecamm. And it's like, so watch some of Diana's old streams, because Diana, you see her looking up like, I said this was going to be a short stream, and it was 3 hours. And I'm like, see, because this was before me and Diana became friends, me in the comments of, short Diana. Click, click,
exactly.
Click, click. That's me clacking. Click, 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 click.
Exactly.
Short Diana.
Holy cow. It never happens. Okay, guys, one short, 1 hour, maybe one and a half hour. 3 hours later, I don't know what's happening now. I might as well go to the next question.
Go for the gusto. All right, sorry, guys.
And I'm totally into, like, doing that when I don't have other appointments and things like that.
Exactly. Life, you know, like, breathing, you know, eating, business. Things like that.
Oh, we missed Doc.
Doc, you mad late, brother. What's wrong with you? No. Where's the cookies?
I was about to say, wait, Indy.
Where's the cookies?
Yes. A video and a stream to answer all of your questions about bringing audio into Clubhouse and Clubhouse audio into your live stream is coming. I promise you, Ben. So stick around. Make sure, I know you're new to the community, so turn on those notifications. We will be digging into that in a much deeper way very soon. But if you watch the replay of this, if you missed it, India did give you a little tidbit of how to set that up. So, you were getting your meal prep. We're less important than your meal prep, Doc. What? Wow, I'm
hurt. Hold on. Hold on. Let me get something for him.
Yeah. your Roadcaster audio does come in a little low. But
it's because I don't want to have it so loud. Yeah, that's why. So I lower the sound effects and blow people's brains. Right, exactly.
Yeah. The judge gavel is the best. Because you don't know it's coming. And it pow, pow. Okay, never mind. Exactly. There you go.
Okay, so more Roadcast. I see your desire to get into Roadcaster Pro. We will do a lot more on that in the future then. Thank you both for joining me and for playing, you know, just completely on the fly and coming in and sharing your knowledge. Make sure everybody knows where to find you.
So I'm the only India Delgado on YouTube. India like the country, Delgado like the Spanish Puerto Rican mommy that I am. India Delgado, you can find me.
No, that was the wrong sound effect.
I did not. I'm about to say I didn't hit anything.
That's Mexican, not Spanish.
Yeah, try that again.
I did not hit anything.
That's all right. Let's bring it back to Brooklyn. Let's reel that back in. Yurt. Forget it. I digress. India Delgado. Okay. Diana, what do you got?
I'm sorry. I totally screwed that one up.
It's all right. That's okay.
I hope I can. I'm Diana Gladney at DianaGladney.com. You can find me on YouTube.com/
Thanks, your tech coach. He or she got us covered.
That's Kathleen.
Oh, Kathleen. It's Kathleen. She got us covered. She's like, these guys over here, let me get it together.
Oh, goodness.
Okay. So India Delgado, Diana Gladney, you guys definitely follow them. And if these ladies will be willing to come back on, I will have them on
absolutely.
A lot more as well. Okay. Having a great time as always. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you.
To dance this baby out?
I'm ready.
Oh,
let's
gosh,
do it.
I forgot about this part.
She's about to end. She's about to hit disconnect right now. Hang up right now. Hold on. No, you have to stay.
I need a dancing gift. All right, let's get this out of the way.
Okay, all right, get it out of the way. Put your dancing.
All right, I'm ready. I'll try. You know, this is never before seen footage here.
Doc did it. So you have to doctor his, you know, the two-step, how we do. Because that's what I'm going to do, the two-step. Let's get it.
I'll figure something out. I'll think of something.
All right, we will see you tomorrow. Bye.
Bye, guys.
Say bye, everyone.